Thank you. And what we don't want. Now we're going to look at traditional neutral zone forechecks. Traditional neutral zone forecheck for most of us when we're teaching our team involves what? Quick up, okay, get the puck going fast, right up. Okay? D to D, stretch, D to D, middle, D to D, flat, long, wide pass, D to D, hinge, or skating hinge. Those are your options in the neutral zone. So you want to practice those. Over the years, we would practice them all the time. As quick as we can, clean puck movement, don't juggle the passes. If you coach at minor hockey, my big thing in junior was we did so many reps of passing drills, and every drill we did, I gave them 4 times they could juggle the pass. And if they did it more than 4, we were skating. We'd skate. We'd break the drill and we'd skate. They had 4 times. Every drill we'd do, depending on how it was going, I'd go 1, 2, 3. That's it. We're skating. Okay? And so what happened was, is when you start to count, what happens? Some kids may get nervous, but they don't usually get too nervous. You're only practicing. So what do they do? They focus. They concentrate. And a lot of, for me, passing, receiving, and practice is focus and concentration. Because if I'm coming through and I'm going to get the puck, you pass it to me in a practice and it bounces off my stick 3 feet, I still go get it. I still complete the drill. I still get my shot on goal. But if you let those habits creep into your practice, that's why we have a big problem in the game. The difference between minor hockey and major junior is puck movement, both passing and receiving. Okay. The difference at the NHL level, it's astronomical. Get down on the boards with the Canucks, go to a practice, get down on the boards, and watch them pass the puck, and watch them receive the puck at high speeds. Watch them, a good example, Sven Barchi, who the Canucks have now, we had in Portland. After practice, Sven wanted us, he would just skate up and down the boards, and he would have a coach there at center ice with a 10, 15, 20 pucks. And he'd say, pass it anywhere. He'd skate down the boards, and you'd pass it behind him, he'd try and reach and pull it. You'd pass it into his skates, he'd put both of them on an angle and touch it up. He'd reach back with the other one, kick it up. He'd reach out with one hand, grab the pass. And to me, it was a really good coaching moment for me to look at this kid in his practice habits. He wanted the puck at full speed, like Sid does. Sid's really good that way. Sid practices the exact same thing all the time. He doesn't care. He'll never get mad at you in practice if you give him a bad pass. He loves it because it's a challenge of accepting the bad pass at full speed and continuing on. But for you, if you're coaching at those levels, passing and receiving, don't allow the bad habits to creep in because you cannot execute on the breakout, you can't execute in the neutral zone, you can't execute in the offensive zone or on the power play if you can't pass and receive the puck clean. You have to do it clean.